In this lecture, we'll be detailed discuss about clavicle, but is it come under osteology? So before we really go for that, I would like to explain a human skeleton too. So in human skeleton, we have a total 206 bone approximately. It may be less or more depending upon different population and ethnicity. Then, generally and regionally, the human skeleton is subdivided into two main divisions. We have axial skeleton, the skeleton that lie at vertical position, and the bone include bone of the skull, vertebral column, bone of the vertebral column, thoracic cage, and we have appendicular skeleton that consists of upper limb and lower limb, including shoulder girdle bone and pelvic girdle bone. Now, to total these bone, we have 126 bone and appendicular skeleton with the 80 bone and axial skeleton, and when we sum up, so it become 206 approximately, as I mentioned before. So it is not exactly the same value. Then the next classification of skeleton or bone based on the development of its origin. So some of the bone ossify in membrane, and they call this membranous, and some of the bone ossify in cartilage. Mostly they ossify in cartilage, so the name they known as cartilaginous bone. And some of the bone ossify mix. First they start ossification in membrane, then switch up to cartilage. So one of the example of such bone is clavicle. Membranous bone include some bone of the skull and facial bone. They ossify in membrane, but not total bone of the skull and facial bone. Some of the bone of the skull and some facial bone. Then cartilaginous bone. As I mentioned before, most of the bone of skeleton ossify in cartilage. So this is limbs bone, bone of upper limb and lower limb, and bone of the vertebral column and thoracic cage. So these bone are classified in the cartilage. Then we have mixed type of bone. An example of such bone is clavicle. That is our main topic, and we will discuss later about in more detail. Then we have the next bone, mandible, occipital, and temporal sphenoid also has the mixed origin of ossification. Then we have the next classification of bone that based on the shape and some other characteristic too. So we have based on this classification, we have long bones, and then long bones further they classify it into a short tubular bone. It includes metacarpal bone and metatarsal bone, and we have B group. This is long tubular bone. An example of such bone is humerus. Then we have short bone. These bone approximately equal in length and width. So these are carpal bone and tarsal bone. And we have flat bone. They are flat in shape. These include ribs, sternum, scapula, and bone of the calvaria. Then we have irregular bone that don't fit into other category. Their shape are irregular, and these are vertebrae, hip bone, and some bone of in the skull of in the base of skull. Then we have pneumatic bone. The pneumatic bone are those bones that contain air cell. For example, maxilla, we have maxillary sinus here in the maxilla region. And we have sphenoid bone at the back of this area. Posteriorly, we have sphenoidal sinus and ethmoid bone that contain three group of air cells, anterior, posterior, and medial. We'll be discussing that. This is other topic. Then we have sesamoid bone. Sesamoid bone usually occur at the in the tendon. For example, patella, and it reduces tension in the tendon and the muscle, and friction as well. Then other example of such bone is fusiform. Then we have accessory bone. Accessory bone are present in the skull suture. They are mostly present in the sutures of skull. And the last one is heterotrophic bone. So it is appear in non-skeletal tissue, like muscle or other tissue, but it must be non-skeletal, or it is, you can say, ectopic bone. And one of the example of this bone is rider bone, rider's bone. It appear at the horse rider, at the inner thigh. Specifically say at the adductor longus muscle. So it's required no treatment if it's not hurt. If it's not hurting, it's required no treatment.